The last class we have seen exercise 3.3, page number 37, 1-2 sums. Now we'll see the third question. What is the third sum they have given? The numbers 13 and 31. The numbers 13 and 31 are prime numbers. 13 is a prime number and 31 is also a prime number. Okay, both these numbers have same digits. See, by observing these two numbers, we can observe we are having the same digits. 13, 31, 1, 3, 3, 1. So, we are having the same digits. 1 and 3. Okay? Now, find two more such pairs of prime numbers below 100. So, same process. 13 is a prime number, 31 is a prime number. In 13 and 31, we are having the same digits. Like that only we have to take two more examples. Okay, that also from below 100. Below 100 we have to take. Okay, now let me see. Now, see what we can say. 37, 73. 37 is a prime number and 73 is also a prime number. When you reverse the numbers also, we get 7 and 3 numbers only. Okay? Same process. 17 is a prime number. 71 is also a prime number. So, when you are reversing the same numbers, we are getting the same number. See, 37, 73, 17, 71. Like this, we have to take some more examples. So here they are asked for only two pairs. No, have written two pairs. So you have to try some more examples and you have to write. Okay. Therefore, the pair of prime numbers below 100 are 37, 73, 17, 71. Okay, children, you understand? Now we'll see the next question. First number is 18. For 18 we had to find two odd primes. 5 is a prime number. When you are taking two prime numbers, if you add the two numbers, we have to get 18. Okay, so 13 is a prime number, 5 is a prime number. So we are adding these two numbers. 13 plus 5 equal to 18. Same process, 17 plus 1, 18. 11 plus 7, 18. Okay, do you understand? Like this, we are having the second one. What is the second number? 24. So, 24. How we can write 19 plus 5? We can write or not? 19 is a prime number, 5 is a prime number. Okay, next. 17 plus 7. We can write or not? 17 is a prime number, 7 is a prime number. So when you are adding these two prime numbers, we are getting 24. Okay, do you understand? Like this, you have to write some more examples. Next number is 36. Next number is 36. For 36 also same process. 31 plus 5. 31 is a prime number, 5 is a prime number. When you are adding these two prime numbers, we are getting 36. Okay, next. 29 plus 7. 29 is a prime number, 7 is a prime number. When you are adding these two numbers, we are getting 36. Okay, like this we have to write the two odd prime children. Okay, in this you are having one more sum, 44. 44. How we can write? 41 plus 3. We can write or not? 41 plus 3. Next, 37 plus 7. 37 is a prime number, 7 is a prime number. When you are adding these two numbers, we are getting 44. Okay, children, do you understand the sum? Okay, now we'll see the next sum. See the next one. What is the next sum? They have given 5th question. Write 7 consecutive composite numbers less than 100. Okay, what is the question that I have given? Write 7 consecutive composite numbers. Consecutive means in a order, means in one order we have to write. Means for example 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27. Means in same order we have to get continue. Those next consecutive composite numbers, that also composite numbers. Composite numbers means the numbers which are having more than two factors are called composite numbers. A numbers which are having more than two factors are called composite numbers. Means seven. How many numbers we have to write? Seven consecutive composite numbers. Seven numbers in order we have to get. Okay. For those less than 100 we have to write. So see, Nana, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96. Total 7 numbers. We got it. See, 90 is divisible by 5 table, 10 table, 2 table also it is divisible. Means for 90 we are having more than 2 factors. So it is a composite number. 91 in a 7 table it is divisible, 30 table it is divisible, 91 table it is divisible, means it is also having more than 2 factors. 92, 2 means easily we can say it is divisible by 2, means here also we are having more than 2 factors. 93 means in 3 table it is divisible. Next, 94, 4 means easily we can say it is divisible by 2. 95, 5 means it is usable by 5 table. 96, 6 means it is usable by 2 table. Okay, means we are having more than 2 factors. So these are the composite numbers. That also, how many numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 numbers we got it. 7 numbers in order we got it. So these are 7 consecutive composite numbers. Okay children, do you understand? Now we'll see the next sum. What is the next question they have given? 6th one, see. Right. Two prime numbers whose difference is 10. Okay, what is the question they have given? Write two prime numbers. Write two prime numbers whose difference is 10. Means here we have to take two prime numbers. Those two prime numbers difference must be 10. Okay, now see the sum. For example, 3, 13. 3, 13. 3 is a prime number, 13 is a prime number. When we are observing these two numbers, what is the difference we got it here? 10. So same process, we can say 7, 17. Okay, 7 is a prime number, 17 is a prime number. Next, 1, 11. 1 is a prime number, 11 is a prime number. So, next, some more examples. 37, 47. 37 is a prime number, 47 is a prime number. Okay children, do you understand? Like this, we have to write some more examples. I have given 4 examples. You have to continue and you have to write some more examples. Okay? Now we'll see the next sum. Next sum. What is the next sum they have given? 7th one. Right. See? subscribe you.